Guys, in this video, we want to look at septal surgeries. We are looking at what nose? So basically the nasal septum, right? For the septum, we can do a lot of surgeries. So for a deviated nasal septum, there are so many options like SMR, that is submucous resection of nasal septum, which is an older or a radical technique. And then you have septoplasty, which is more conservative and it preserves most of the septum. Okay, so these are two surgeries. We will come to them. Then what are other surgeries? Other surgeries like you have septal perforation surgery, etc. Those we have covered in a different video, right? With the septal button, they will try to cover the septal perforation. So we have already seen this where they will put a button, right? And they will kind of close these holes. Right. So anyways, that has a separate video. In this video, we want to cover what? The deviated nasal septum, how to fix, right? So there are two options, SMR, that is submucous resection of nasal septum, and septoplasty. Like we told you, this one, submucous resection of nasal septum, is a more radical one. It is replaced now completely with septoplasty. Septoplasty, basically it tries to retain much of the septal framework as much as possible, and here the mucoperichondrial or the periosteal flap is raised only on one side, but in this one, in SMR, they are raising the flap on both sides. Okay, so both sides of the septum, they will try to raise the flaps, and in this one, they will try to raise the flap only on one side, right? Okay, we will look at the differences, but just look at the steps here in SMR, that is submucous resection of nasal septum, right? So you can see the septum, it's deviated here, and both the sides, they have shown you the flaps. They have raised the flap on this side, and now they are raising the flap on the other side also. So both the sides, they raise the flaps, right? And now the black part, the septum is almost, they have removed, and now they have rejoined these flaps. Right, so this is SMR, so this is more radical. Septoplasty, again, there are many versions, but just look at the basic thing. The basic thing you have to understand here is that the flap is raised only on one side and they have tried to fix it. Okay, so how's it going, people? So what are we learning today? Difference between what? SMR and septoplasty, right? Septoplasty. And what is the other thing that we want to learn? SMR. The difference between these two we want to learn. So let's look at the differences one by one. SMR, it is extensive dissection of septum. Okay. Removing all deformed bony and cartilaginous part. They are removing most of the deformed parts. Preserving only a caudal and dorsal strut of cartilage. So very minimally they are retaining the septal parts. Okay. Then, this SMR is actually not done before 17 years. Mucoperichondrial and periosteal flaps raised on both sides of the septum. This is the basic thing you have to understand. Both sides of the septum it's raised. Bony and cartilaginous parts are excised. So, whatever they think is deformed, deviated, etc., those parts they are excising. So, continuing, more chances of complications. Where are the more chances of complications, guys? In SMR. Okay, in this, there are more chances of complications. What are the complications? Supratip depression, columellar recession, flapping of septum. All these three they have mentioned. What in all complications they are telling? Supratip depression, columellar recession, flapping of septum. So, there are more chances of complications in what? In SMR. Okay. Then, last point, what they are saying? Reoperation is difficult. Okay. So, you understood? That SMR, what and all you saw, both the sides, they will raise the flaps. What flaps? Mucoperichondrial and periosteal flaps are raised on both sides. Whatever deviated, deformed part of bony and cartilaginous septum, they are removing. There are more complications and reoperation is difficult. It is not done before 17 years. Is that correct? Let's check. Okay, you're removing all deformed bony and cartilaginous parts. Okay, it's not done before 17 years. Yes. Both sides you will raise these mucoperichondrial and periosteal flaps. Okay, then what else we saw? more chances of complication. Complications are supratip depression and columella recession, flapping of septum. Columella is which part? This part. Columella. Now, shall we move on to septoplasty, guys? So, septoplasty, you remember, right? They are going to raise the flap only on one side and they have corrected the septum, right? See, there are many approaches, but this one is the where they are going via the concave side, right? This is the concave side. Via the concave side, they have raised and they have fixed it. They can go from convex side, raise the flap here and shave off this part. So, either this or that, but they raise it only on one side and work only on one side. See, for septoplasty, there are three things, okay? Either you go from the concave part or you go from the, so you go from the concave part or you go from the convex part and you work on it. Or there is a third option here where this one, see what you're looking at now, this one's the third option where they are saying that dislocated septal cartilage can be replaced in the maxillary groove or on the anterior nasal spine by excision of the cartilage along the floor of nose and fixing it with a suture. So, they are showing some suture here, right? They are going by the floor of the nose, okay? So, a third approach, but just you remember this much. What will you remember? That either you can go from the concave side or the convex side, but they will raise it only at one side, okay? Now, let us look at the details of septoplasty. Limited selective dissection, removing minimal cartilage and bone. Okay, so they are removing minimal cartilage and bone. This is what you have to understand. Okay, consistent with providing a good airway. Most of the cartilage and bone is preserved. This is what is green for us, right? Most of the cartilage and bone is preserved. Okay, so that is what you have to focus on. Even deformed parts are corrected. They are correcting the deformed parts and reimplanted between the mucoperichondrial and the periosteal flaps. So, between these flaps, whatever was deformed, they are correcting them and reimplanting them. Now, septoplasty can be done even in children. So, this is what is important. It can be done even in children without affecting nasal growth. Flaps are raised only on one side and limited elevation on opposite side. So, opposite side they can raise, they are saying, but limited elevation. So, this is something that we are adding to the existing information, right? There can be limited elevation on the opposite side, okay? Then, how's it going, people? We are looking at what? Septoplasty, right? So, deformed cartilage is corrected. So, whatever is deformed, they are trying to correct, right? That's what they are saying. Correct, reimplant, etc. How will they correct the deformed cartilage? By scoring, cross-hatching, wedge excision. Okay, there are some techniques and realigning in the groove of the nasal crest. So, they are correcting it, realigning it, etc. They are giving some techniques for this. Scoring, cross-hatching, wedge excision, etc. Sometimes straight pieces are joined outside the nose and replaced between the flaps. So, they will take the straight pieces, join it outside the nose and replace it between the flaps. This is called as extracorporeal septoplasty. Okay. And in case of spur, only spurrectomy is done. Spur means what? Deviated septum has a spur, right? Spur is like a shelf-like projection. So, spur is a shelf-like projection found on the junction of bone and cartilage. Shelf-like projection. So, basically spur can cause what? Spur can cause epistaxis, headaches, etc., right? So, in case of spur, they will only do a spurrectomy, isn't it? That's what they said, isn't it? What did they say? Spurrectomy is done, okay. So, in case of this septoplasty, there will be less chance of complications and reoperation is easier. You can do a reoperation, okay. So, they can do this even in children. That's what you have to remember, septoplasty. Guys, let's do one thing now. Let us look at the indications. Why would anybody do a SMR operation? Why would they do? What would be the cause for such a operation which they think is more radical, right? Let us see what the indications are for an SMR, okay? Indications for SMR. So if there's a deviated nasal septum causing symptoms of nasal obstruction and recurrent headache, so you should not write deviated nasal septum alone. Remember the full sentence, deviated nasal septum along with what? Nasal obstruction and headache. So this guy should have what and all? He should have a deviated nasal septum along with nasal obstruction and he should have a nice headache. Okay, then only you can, this is an indication for SMR. DNS causing obstruction to the ventilation of paranasal sinuses and middle ear resulting in recurrent sinusitis and otitis media. Again here DNS, but not just DNS. What DNS? Causing obstruction to ventilation of the paranasal sinuses, middle ear, and it will be middle ear means otitis media and obstruction to paranasal sinuses, so recurrent sinusitis. So deviated nasal septum obstructing the sinuses causing sinusitis and DNS causing obstruction to middle ear causing otitis media. Okay, so what and all you saw now? Deviated nasal septum causing obstruction to what? Nasal obstruction. Then this guy is having headache. Then this guy is having paranasal sinus obstruction leading to sinusitis. And then middle ear obstruction leading to what? Otitis media. Okay guys, we are continuing with what? The indications of this SMR, submucous resection of nasal septum. Okay, recurrent epistaxis from septal spur. Septal spur can lead to recurrent epistaxis, yes. Then, as a part of septorhinoplasty for cosmetic correction of external nasal deformity, some cosmetic correction. Then, as a preliminary step in hypophysectomy, as a preliminary step in hypophysectomy, what is that? That is transseptal, transsphenoidal approach or Vidian neurectomy. Some Vidian nerve, right? Vidian neurectomy, transseptal approach. Something really complicated here, but if you want, you can remember this. It's a preliminary step in some surgeries. Okay. So you got the indications for this SMR operation. What are the contraindications? You should not do it in children below 17 years of age. You should not do, right? Then, if the person has diabetes, hypertension, you should not do. If they have acute episode of respiratory infection, you should not do. Okay. Bleeding diathesis, you should not do. So just let us check the complications, complete complications. Okay, bleeding is a complication. Then what else they are saying? Septal hematoma. Then what else they are telling? Other complications are septal abscess. Then perforation. Then depression of bridge. Okay, then retraction of columella. Then persistence of deviation. Deviation can still remain. Persistence of deviation. Flapping of septum. Yes. And then toxic shock syndrome. Can you say the complications of SMR? Say bleeding.
Bleeding.
Septal hematoma.
Septal hematoma.
Septal abscess.
Septal abscess.
Perforation.
Perforation.
Depression of bridge.
Depression of bridge.
Retraction of.
Retraction of.
Columella.
Columella.
Then persistence of deviation.
Persistence of deviation.
Flapping of septum.
Flashing of
flapping.
Septum.
Flapping.
Flashing.
Flapping.
Flapping of septum.
Toxic shock syndrome.
Toxic shock
syndrome. Thank you. Guys, let us look at the indications for septoplasty. So what do we want to look at? Indications of septoplasty. Okay. So basically the septoplasty, similar indications only are there. Deviated nasal septum with nasal obstruction causing headache. Same thing, almost same things are there here. And spur, right? Spur, recurrent epistaxis, sinusitis, same things are there. Cosmetic reasons, then almost same thing, only some extra information is there. If you want, you can look at this. Okay. But they look the same almost. Guys, chances of complication are less in septoplasty, okay? But the thing is, when you list the complications, they are the same only. Bleeding, septal hematoma, abscess, septal perforation, supratip depression, saddle nose deformity, then what and all, Vinosono, same thing. Bleeding, septal hematoma, abscess, septal perforation, supratip depression, saddle nose deformity, columella retraction, persistence of the deviation, CSF rhinorrhoea, rarely. Then toxic shock syndrome, it's almost the same. Same thing only. Okay, but the chance of these complications are less. Okay. Guys, when it comes to the septoplasty, there are some types of incisions that you can know if you want. There is a Killian's incision. Okay. Transfixion. Right. Then hemitransfixion. Horizontal on the spur. Some four septal incisions are there. So guys, in this video, we wanted to look at the deviated nasal septum surgery. So we have SMR versus septoplasty. We wanted to look at the difference. So basically, we saw that SMR, they are going to raise the flaps on both the sides and they're going to remove most of the deformed bony and cartilaginous part of the nasal septum, right? And this is not done in children and it has more complications. So reoperation is difficult. Lot of complications we listed. Coming to septoplasty, we saw that they raise the flap only on one side, either on the concave side or the convex side. And convex means they'll shave off the part and concave means they are trying to align it. And most of the bony and cartilaginous part of the septum are preserved. Even if it is deformed, they try to repair and re-implant, right? And it can be done even in children. Then there are less chance of complications, though the complications and indications are almost the same, right? And this operation, re-operation is easier in septoplasty. What else we saw? Septal surgeries means you can also talk about septal perforation surgery with the septal button, etc. That we have covered in a different video. So in this video, we saw what the differences between SMR and septoplasty. Bye!
Bye!